Let's assume that you have already developed your themes using QDA Miner Lite. How do you develop visual representation and also export your results so that you can start writing your findings? As you can see here, we have our themes here, the themes that are addressing the first research question and the themes that are addressing the second research question. So let's say you want to export the themes. There are many ways to export it. One way is to right click here and go to print code, and then instead of printing, you can change it to PDF, and then you can click on print, but it's going to save that information in a PDF format. So let's try it and see. And then you can give it a name. So maybe themes for research questions 1 and 2. You can see here you have your themes and under their respective research questions. So this is what you're going to see if you export only the themes under each of the research question. That's the first way of exporting the themes. You can also export the themes by going to Code Retriever. So when you click on Code Retriever, you'll be able to retrieve the code by going here, click on this one, you select the themes that you want to retrieve. We want to retrieve all the themes. And you click on Search. This is what you're going to get. You're going to get for the category column, there are the research questions. And when you look at the second column, the themes or the codes that you have developed, in this case, they are the themes, right? And so the participants that are connected to the theme. So you can see that the first theme here, this one is connected to participant one, and the significant information that was selected that has been connected to this theme. So these are the significant information from the data, and these are the themes, and these are the participants. Let me enlarge it a little bit. These are just the number of words. This information is not all that important. So what you can do is you can export it by going here, you click on save, and then you can look for the place to save and then give it the file name so that you can save that information. We can try to save and see what we're going to get, right? So the themes for the study, and let's save it here. So it's asking you whether you want to open it right now. You can see that it has been saved in Excel format. So you have all the research question and also the codes and participant. In case you want to group them based on the research question, you can select here and then go to A to Z, like you are sorting. Let me go here. So you see here that now you have all the research question and their respective codes or themes and the significant information and participants that are connected to each of the themes that you have. So that's how you're going to do it. You can, you know, arrange it any way that you want, and then you can use it as part of presenting your findings. So this one can be very useful. Let's say if you are talking about a theme and then you want to quote participants, if you want to quote participant P2, you can just copy this one and then use it as evidence in support of a theme. So that's how you can use this one. So let's go back. Another thing I want to show here is that you can arrange them based on categories. So the categories are based on the research question. So you can arrange it, the table based on the information here, based on the research question. So you see how when I do that, you can see that all the information under research question 1 is here, all the information under research question 2 is also here. And you can group them based on the codes that you develop, or you can arrange them based on the cases each participant and the codes or the themes that are connected to a specific participant, right? You can see that for participant 1, these are the themes that are connected to participant 1. So, and then you can export it or you can save this information, right? So this is what you can get. So let's go to another place, Test Retriever. So let's say you want to retrieve all the significant information that was selected. You go to Retrieve, Test Retriever, and then you can select code segment, and then you select the significant information that are connected to a specific theme, or if you are looking for all the themes, you can select all of them. In case you want to select some of them, you can click here, but if you want to select all of them, then you can click all, and then you click on retrieve all units and click on search, and the system will retrieve everything for you, all the significant information that were coded. So that's what you can get here. The next place that you could go is list comment. Let's say you made a lot of comments, like you wrote a memo and you want to look at all the reflections that you have written. Here is the place. I didn't write anything. That's why you don't see anything here. And another place that you can go is analyze, and you can click on coding frequency. The only function that you can use is coding frequency. So you click on that, and then you can select. Normally I select everything, I select all the themes, and then I can click on search. So this is what you're going to see. If you want to see in a table form, this is what you're going to see. This is a place where you can also do a very good visual representation. So if you want to do any visual representation, you can select all of them or select the portions that you want. But if you want all of them, you can select that and then go to chat here. If you want to create a word cloud, this is what you're going to create. You can see that all the themes, the bigger the font, the higher the number of significant information connected to it. So you can see that this theme, there's a lot of significant information connected to it. If you want to know the significant information, you can go to this chat. So you can see here that having higher workload, this shows percentage of code. It's not all that clear. So what you can do, you can go to frequency. Frequency is a number of significant information connected to a specific code. So this one, you choose this one, and then you can see that having high workload, you can see that you have 7 significant information connected to this one. This one is 3 significant information. This one is also 4. If you want to know the number of cases, like the number of participants connected to a specific theme, you click on the number of cases and you can see that 3 participants are connected to this one. 3 participants, 2 participants are connected to this. And you can change it the way that you want, that makes sense for you. You don't have to use all of these visual representation if it doesn't make sense, if it's not adding meaning to the information that you're going to present. You don't have to present that information, not all of them that you can show. So here you can see that we are talking about a number of participants connected to a theme, and the bigger the font, the higher the number of participants. So you can see here that this one is big in font. So you can see that this theme is dominant compared to others. So that's how you can do that. And as I said, you can save it if you want to use it. You can just explore and save the ones that you like. So this is what I have for you. This is how you can use this free software to analyze your data and also develop visual representation. If you have any question, let me know. I'll be happy to address them for you. Thank you for your time.